Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a show where we'll provide you fresh insights into South Asia's geopolitical, strategic and security situation. Let's begin the show with the headlines first. Indian Army thwarts Pakistani border action team attack in Jammu and Kashmir's Kupwara. Pakistani army launches brutal crackdown on thousands of protesters in Gwadar, Balochistan. And electricity bill crisis sparks massive demonstrations across Pakistan. India's security forces have ramped up their operations to dismantle the complex web of Pakistan-backed terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir. This intensified action is in direct response to Islamabad's ongoing and aggressive attempts to infiltrate and carry out terror attacks in the region. Despite these challenges, the Indian Army, working in close partnership with Jammu and Kashmir Police, remains resolute in its efforts to combat terrorism and ensure peace. Recently, the Indian Army successfully thwarted an attack by Pakistan's Border Action Team in Machil sector of Kupwara district, demonstrating their commitment to maintaining security and stability in the area.
The Indian Army has successfully thwarted an attack by Pakistan's Border Action Team in the Machil sector of Jammu and Kashmir's Kupwara district. Taking advantage of poor weather and visibility conditions, a group of 2 to 3 armed personnel crossed the line of control and fired on a forward army post at close range. The Indian Army responded vigorously, resulting in the death of one Pakistani intruder and the recovery of weapons, ammunition and warlike stores. However, during the intense exchange of fire, 5 Indian soldiers were gravely injured and evacuated to the base hospital in Srinagar. Tragically, one of the critically injured soldiers succumbed to his injuries.
In this operation too, one soldier has been martyred and 5 have been injured, including a major. This clearly indicates Pakistan's evil intentions and its deviousness, because in the latest encounter, the Pakistani Border Action Team was involved, which consists of Pakistani regular commandos who were assisting the Atankwadis. This is a very, very serious escalation on part of Pakistan.
Similar infiltration attempts, actively supported by the Pakistani army, have exploited thick foliage and poor visibility, but have always been successfully thwarted. Pakistan provides training and funding to terrorists to infiltrate Jammu and Kashmir and launch attacks on security forces and civilians. Despite these challenges, the Indian Army remains resolute in maintaining the sanctity of the LOC and defeating the nefarious designs of the Pakistan Army. In a related development, the Border Security Force foiled a major infiltration bid in Jammu and Kashmir's Samba on August 1. Where alert BSF personnel gunned down one intruder attempting to cross the Indian border.
रात को करीब 10:15 बजे हमारे जो फॉरवर्ड ड्यूटी पॉइंट्स हैं उसमें हरकत देखा कि एक जो ह्यूमन बीइंग है इंसान वो पाकिस्तान से आईबी के अंदर एंटर हो रहा है तो उसको इमीडिएटली ऑब्जर्व किया गया ट्रूप्स अलर्ट थे बाकी जो उनके आसपास थे सबको अलर्ट किया गया वो जब अंदर आया तो उसको चैलेंज किया गया तो जैसे ही चैलेंज किया उसने भागने की कोशिश की और ट्रूप्स ने पोजीशन लेके उसके ऊपर फायर किया और उसको रात को न्यूट्रलाइज कर दिया गया ऐसा लगता है कि आज से
मुनीर Amid the recent surge in terror attacks in Jammu and Kashmir, former Director General of Police SP Vaid disclosed that over 600 SSG commandos from the Pakistan Army have been earmarked for this mission. He further claimed that some of these commandos have already infiltrated Jammu and Kashmir and are executing terror attacks.
Pakistan ki taraf se koshish ki ja rahi hai कि हाईली ट्रेन्ड टेररिस्ट भेजे जाएं और इस एरिया को, जम्मू जो पिछले 15 साल से फ्री था, टेररिज्म फ्री, उसको यहाँ वायलेंस का लेवल बढ़ाया जाए। और रिपोर्ट्स के मुताबिक इसमें एसएसजी कमांडोज पाकिस्तान आर्मी के भी हैं, और इनफैक्ट एक रिपोर्ट तो कहती है कि वहाँ जो एसएसजी कमांडो यूनिट के जीओसी आदिल रहमानी हैं, वो इसके इंचार्ज है, एंड वो आदिल रहमानी सारे ऑपरेशन को कोऑर्डिनेट कर रहा है। और जितना भी नंबर यहाँ अंदर घुसा है उसमें काफ़ी मिकदार में एसएसजी के लोग पाकिस्तान आर्मी के हैं।
The Union Territory has witnessed dozens of terror attacks in the last 3 months. The Jammu region, which experienced relative peace from 2005 to 2021, has seen a resurgence of terrorist activities, including a deadly attack on a pilgrim bus, resulting in 9 fatalities and 40 injuries. According to the Ministry of Home Affairs, a total of 28 people, including civilians and security personnel, were killed in 11 terror-initiated incidents and 24 counters or counter-terror operations up to July 21 this year. Terrorist activities began to re-emerge in October 2021, particularly in this border districts of Poonch and Rajouri. Security officials believe these lethal attacks spreading to Riyasi, Kathua and Doda are efforts by Pakistani handlers to revive terrorism in the Jammu region. Despite India's relentless efforts to maintain peace, the situation in Kashmir remains precarious due to Pakistan's ongoing support and promotion of terrorist activities. The Pakistani intelligence agency ISI continues to be a breeding ground for anti-India forces, aiding and abetting groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed.
Moving on, in Pakistan's Balochistan province, a wave of violence and repression has erupted as Pakistani authorities crack down on a major movement for self-determination. The Baloch National Gathering, or Baloch Raji Muchi, aimed at uniting Baloch leaders and advocates, has been met with brutal force, resulting in bloodshed and widespread arrests. Here's a closer look at the unfolding situation.
Gunfire echoes through the streets, blood stains the ground, and arrests are rampant. Balochistan is engulfed in turmoil. On July 28, thousands of Baloch people converged near Gwadar for the Baloch National Gathering, a platform to advocate for their rights and discuss aspirations for self-determination. But the Baloch Yakjahiti Committee reports that Pakistani security forces violently attacked the peaceful sit-in, detaining 12 women and 50 men, including prominent activists. This violent response follows protests where Baloch demonstrators demanded control over their natural resources and opposed government deals with China. Despite the intimidation, activist Mahrang Baloch remains resolute in continuing the fight for Baloch rights.
ये सब रियासत पाकिस्तान की जानिब से हो रही है। मैं आप सब से यही गुजारिश करती हूँ कि आप सब लोग इस जबर और इस नस्ल कुशी के खिलाफ आएं और बलोच तहरीक और बलोच यकजहती कमेटी का साथ दें। और इस दरमियान अगर बलोच यकजहती कमेटी के कारकुनान और किसी को भी जो भी नुकसान पहुंचाए, उसकी जिम्मेदारी स्टेट ऑफ पाकिस्तान की है, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ बलोचिस्तान की है, जिसके ऑर्डर्स पर पीसफुल मुजाहरीन पर तशद्दुद किया गया। पीसफुल मुजाहरीन आज भी, जिनकी लाशें जीडीए हॉस्पिटल और मुख्तलिफ अस्पतालों में पड़ी हुई है, जिन लाशों को देखने के लिए भी हमें इजाजत नहीं दी जा रही है, और कल को मुझ समेत यहां पर किसी को भी कोई जानी नुकसान पहुंचता है, उसकी जिम्मेदारी स्टेट ऑफ पाकिस्तान और उसकी एजेंसीज की होती है।
द सिटी ऑफ ग्वादर इज नाउ अंडर स्ट्रिक्ट कर्फ्यू एंड सील्ड ऑफ। रिपोर्ट्स रिवील दैट ओवर 1000 लोकल्स हैव बीन अरेस्टेड अमिड द प्रोटेस्ट्स। The region has been cut off from the internal for 3 days, further isolating residents and obstructing information flow about the ongoing violence. Frontier Corps, Pakistani police and death squads are repeatedly beating and torturing residents in the streets.
28 जुलाई राजी मुच्छी का दिन था, जिस दिन हम एक पीसफुल जलसा करने वाले थे, लेकिन रियासत ने गुज़श्ता दो हफ्ते से अपनी पूरी ताकत इस्तेमाल की है कि इस पीसफुल जो एक गैदरिंग है उसको किस तरह रोका जाए। तीन दिन के दौरान हमारे तकरीबन 1000 के करीब साथी अभी तक गिरफ्तार है और हमें कुछ भी नहीं पता है। चार दिन हो चुके हैं कि ग्वादर में नेटवर्क बंद है और यहाँ पे कर्फ्यू नाफिज किया गया है, जहाँ पे एफसी पुलिस और डेथ स्क्वाड के कारण हर गली कूचे में आम लोगों को पकड़ रहे हैं और उनको मार रहे हैं। तकरीबन ग्वादर धरने में अभी दूसरी मरतबा हमें क्रैकडाउन का सामना हुआ है, जिसकी वजह से एफसी और पुलिस ने आकर जो पीसफुल धरना था उसके साथ मुजाकरात करने के बजाय वहां जितने भी इंतजामी थे उन सबको मारा, उन सब पर तशद्दुद किया और अभी तक हमें कुछ नहीं पता है, पूरा शहर बंद है कि उनमें से कितने लोग जिंदा हैं और कितने लोग जख्मी हैं।
इन अ शॉकिंग डेवलपमेंट, अ वीडियो शेयर्ड बाय पाकिस्तानी मीडिया आउटलेट ऑन एक्स शोज पाकिस्तान आर्मीज मिलिट्री इंटेलिजेंस सेंडिंग असैसिंस टू टारगेट द बलोच एक्टिविस्ट्स। One of the captured assassins confessed to being sent by the Pakistani army.
Mano Islam mein mai ye mardume mai da kahe mar pistol gung to wapi ta ki gung to aan im ga fc us tama hamla kana is sare sa vision hai sha aur baaki ma is sare de re is sarkar ab
kamera is sare mera naam kahe
tab naam
kahe islam dai naam kahe
zai walid
kahe
walid
The Baloch community continues to endure severe human rights abuses. Enforced disappearances remain a critical issue, with individuals seized by state forces without legal charges, leaving families in agony and victims often subjected to brutal torture. Extrajudicial killings further exacerbate the situation, targeting activists and critics without due process, spreading fear and silencing dissent. In detention, torture and mistreatment are rampant, with victims suffering physical and psychological abuse to extract confessions or suppress opposition. Arbitrary detentions disrupt lives, creating a pervasive atmosphere of fear across the community.
In Pakistan, mounting frustration over skyrocketing electricity bills has ignited widespread protests across the nation. Thousands of demonstrators, led by the Islamist party, Jamaat-e-Islami, are demanding an end to severe taxes and price hikes that have burdened many households. With Pakistan facing unprecedented inflation and escalating energy costs, Jamaat-e-Islami is pledging to intensify their protests until the government addresses their demands for fairer bill practices. Here's the latest on the situation.
On July 29th, protests over skyrocketing power bills brought a major road into Pakistan's capital, Islamabad, to a standstill. Approximately 3,000 supporters of Jamaat-e-Islami, an influential Islamist party, continued their sit-in protest. While waving the white, blue and green flags of Jamaat-e-Islami, protesters chanted slogans against the increase in electricity bills, calling it unacceptable. Jamaat-e-Islami initially issued a call for holding the sit-in near the Parliament building in Islamabad to pressure the government to withdraw a substantial increase in electricity costs that have sparked nationwide outrage. Many people are receiving electricity bills higher than their salaries, adding to their financial burdens. During a rally, Jamaat-e-Islami leader Hafiz Naimur Rahman demanded justice for the nation's 250 million people, urging the government to remove the excessive taxes imposed on electricity bills.
जागीरदारों पे टैक्स लगाओ, आवाम से टैक्स हटाओ, हमारे बिजली के बिलों से टैक्स हटाओ, हमारे बिजली के बिलों से टैक्स हटाओ। ये क्या मजाक है? 36 तरह के टैक्स एक बिल में लगा के भेज देते हो, यूनिट की कीमत भी बढ़ाते जा रहे हो, टैक्स भी इसके ऊपर लगाते जा रहे हो, ये धंधा नहीं चलेगा। इसलिए हमारा बहुत सीधा सीधा मुतालबा है, यहाँ पर हम अपनी जात के लिए नहीं आए, मुझे कुछ नहीं चाहिए, इन्हें कुछ नहीं चाहिए, हमारी पार्टी को कुछ नहीं चाहिए।
Protesters demanding that the government withdraw taxes on electricity to offset price hikes have occupied a road in Rawalpindi since July 26th, as police prevented them from heading to the capital, Islamabad. Jamaat-e-Islami supporters were blocked from entering Islamabad's red zone, which houses top government offices, the diplomatic enclave and Parliament House. Several protesters who attempted to breach the barriers were arrested by police. The protesters who have been camping out in the open are demanding the government to revoke the taxes on electricity to offset the price hikes. They argue that the inflated power bills and new taxation laws in the 2024-25 annual budget have made their lives unbearable.
महंगाई है, बिजली का बिल ज़्यादा आ रहा है, गरीब लोग है, कारोबार तबाह हो गया है, माशियत तबाह हो गया, हर चीज़ तबाह हो गया इन हुकमरानों की वजह से, इन IPPs के लोगों की वजह से। तो इंशाल्लाह हम अपनी मुतालिबात मनवा के इधर से उठेंगे और नाम इधर से जाने वाले नहीं है, हुकूमत ये सोच न करे।
Jamaat-e Islami plans to escalate their protests with a sit-in at the Governor House in Karachi and similar actions in other provincial capitals. Pakistan is grappling with record high inflation affecting essential commodities and services, eroding purchasing power and leaving many citizens struggling to meet basic needs. Increased taxes on energy bills and essential goods have further strained households and businesses. The Pakistan government raised power prices by 26% during the last fiscal year, which ended on June 30th, and imposed another 20% increase on July 13th. Officials state these increases were necessary to meet the IMF's conditions for a $7 billion loan deal finalized earlier in July. The government's recent tax measures aimed at generating revenue and meeting International Monetary Fund's conditions have only fueled public discontent.
As the Pakistan government grapples with escalating financial pressures and the challenges of implementing stringent IMF measures such as increased taxes and currency devaluation, the impact on ordinary citizens is becoming increasingly severe. The rising cost of living continues to put immense pressure on the middle class, making it difficult for families to manage even the most basic necessities. Our report takes a closer look at the struggles faced by consumers and sellers amid this economic turmoil.
Pakistan is facing a profound economic crisis, characterized by skyrocketing inflation and a sharp rise in the cost of essential goods. Despite government assurances of relief, many citizens feel forsaken as their daily expenses relentlessly rise. The soaring prices of essential commodities are wreaking havoc on the lives of ordinary Pakistani citizens. Rampant inflation has made basic food items like vegetables and pulses unaffordable for the middle class, with prices changing drastically within days.
सब्जी की कीमतों पे जो इजाफे हुए हैं, इससे आवाम बहुत परेशान है, महंगाई बहुत ज़्यादा है। हमारी गवर्नमेंट को चाहिए कि ये कम से कम इस चीज़ को कंट्रोल करें, कहाँ पे महंगाई कहाँ से हो रही है। ये लोग सब्जी वाले जो लोग लेके आते हैं, इन्हें जो बीच में पुलिस वाले रोकते हैं, ये वहाँ पे पैसे देते हैं, इस वजह से भी महंगाई है। पेट्रोल में इजाफा, इस वजह से महंगाई है। बिजली के बिलों में इजाफा है, इस वजह से महंगाई ये इतनी महंगाई, ये सारा मेन जो जाता है ना ये गवर्नमेंट के उसमें जाता है। तो गवर्नमेंट को चाहिए कि अपनी कारकर्दगी को जो है ना देखे।
इन जुलाई पाकिस्तान स्ट्रक अ डील विद द इंटरनेशनल मॉनेटरी फंड फॉर अ $7 billion लोन प्रोग्राम विच इंक्लूड्स tough measures such as higher taxes on farm incomes and electricity prices. This prospect has raised concern among poor and middle-class Pakistanis who fear further inflation and higher taxes. As families cut back on meals and stretch their budgets to a breaking point, the human cost of this economic turmoil becomes painfully clear. The lack of government action and accountability is pushing the middle class to the brink.
हुकूमत को चाहिए ना थोड़ा ध्यान देवे, रेट लिस्ट निकाले, थोड़ा तवज्जो दे, गरीबों का ध्यान रखे। तो खाना खराब हो रहा है सबका, खुद तो एसी में रूम में सो रहे हैं और हम लोग परेशान हो रहे हैं।
Inflation in Pakistan has slowed in recent months after hitting more than 30% in 2023. But in June 2024, Pakistan's inflation rate surged to 12.6%, up from 11.8% in May 2024, reversing a downward trend observed over the previous 5 months. The middle class in Pakistan is at a breaking point with no clear end in sight to the price hikes.
ये आगे से सारे माल महंगे आ रहे हैं, एक तो बरसातों ने माल को खराब कर दिया है, दूसरा ये कुछ आगे वालों ने अपना चलान गरीबी के माल नहीं देते, तो इस वजह से जब माल आता है यहाँ पे पहुँचता है तो वैसे ही 150-200 रुपए किलो तक पेटी में बंद पड़ता है। अब दुकानदार क्या करेगा बेचारा, इसमें ये कि दुकानदार भी परेशान है, लेने वाला भी परेशान है, और लेने वाला हमसे बोलता आगे तो जाता नहीं है मंडी, अगर मंडी जाए तो कीमतों का पता चलेगी क्या है कीमत क्या नहीं है।
The government's failure to address the root causes of inflation and implement effective relief measures is evident. Furthermore, one Islamist party, Jamaat-e-Islami, has held protests and threatened sit-ins in major cities if the government does not tackle rising prices. For now, middle-class families continue to bear the brunt of an economic storm that shows no sign of abating.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We'll be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shivangi Mishra signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.